ones? Okay, I thought I could share my screen.
Yes.
But it's no problem. I will do it now. Okay, it's now downloading. So you will do a short introduction.
You can just start off. We have already alerted all our offices and the intro email has already been gone. Like you are hosting the event today and everything is informed prior. And we have also invited a couple of students and our offices as well, the senior counselors and also the prospective students. Yeah. So I hope this is going to be a really good session.
Yeah, I hope so too. So I'm here together with one of our students. She is a second year student from India. And after my presentation, she will share some experiences.
That would be great. Actually, the participants have just started logging in and probably in another like 5 minutes, you can start off the session. So that should be really great.
Yeah, sure. No problem. My presentation is uploaded. I think it should be fine. And how are you there? Where in India are you?
Oh, but apart from that, the situations are quite getting back to normal. Like people are getting used to the mask and the sanitizers. So everything is getting back to normal except for the COVID protocols. And how about the situation in Netherlands? I heard that we are having the second wave in Europe. So how about Netherlands? How is the situation there?
Yeah, that's the same. So we have the second wave and it is now slightly going down, but it is still quite high. There was a press conference last Tuesday and the government has made some kind of regulations a little bit less strict. So for example, some public things like amusement parks, zoos, they were closed for 2 weeks, but they reopened and people can have now 3 visitors at a time instead of 2. But still restaurants and bars are closed. A mask is going to be mandatory from 1st of December in public areas. So yeah, it is still, there is quite a lot of infections.
All right. I really hope, really awaiting the vaccination or any other remedy for the COVID so that people can move out freely as usual.
Yeah, that would be good.
All right. I think we have got the participants in. If you're ready, you can just start off in another 2 minutes or so.
Yes, I will.
Thank you and good luck.
Okay, thank you. Hello, everyone. I hope you can hear me. I had some issues to open my presentation, but I think it's here now. My name is Madelon Nouwen. I'm from Breda University of Applied Sciences in the Netherlands. And I'm here today to give you a presentation about our institute and about the programs that we offer. I'm not alone. I'm here together with one of our students from India. Her name is Apeksha, and she will introduce herself after my presentation and share some of her experiences. So this is the logo of our institute. We changed our name 2 years ago, so it is possible if you are looking for us that you still find some information under the name NHTV. Which is a Dutch abbreviation, and we thought it was more international to change it to Breda University of Applied Sciences. This is a picture of our campus. Also 2 years ago, we moved all the buildings, all the study programs together. Before that, we were spread out over the city in 4 different buildings. But 2 years ago, the university bought an old convent, and now some of our study programs are situated here. In total, we have 3 buildings, and I will share some pictures later. We are a medium-sized institute with just over 7,000 students and almost 800 employees, and both the students and also the lecturers are international. We are situated in the city of Breda in the south of the Netherlands, and I will share a picture of the Netherlands with the situation of Breda later. The institute was founded in 1966 as an institute for tourism and traffic, how it was called at the time, now called logistics. But we have much more study programs now, which I will share with you. What do we stand for? So because we are a relatively small institute with just over 7,000 students, we offer small scale, high quality education. We have diverse, inclusive and cross-cultural learning environment, which means that if you do a certain study program, you can do a minor with another study program. It is diverse because we integrate real life projects into our study programs. And inclusive because we welcome everyone from all around the world, from all kind of backgrounds. So the classroom is very international and very diverse. We are innovative. We always look at the latest developments. And for example, our brand new master supply chain management is developed together with the industry, as also is the gaming program. So we really look at what do companies need and how can we prepare our students as well as possible for that. Then we do relevant research. So depending on the study program and the domain, we do research and we do cooperate with international businesses. These are our 8 domains of expertise. So as I mentioned, we have a long history in tourism and also in logistics. But apart from that, we offer programs in built environment, facility, games, hotel, leisure and events, and media. In all of these domains, we have bachelor programs, and in most of them also master. Each domain is specialized. We connect and make crossovers. Like I mentioned, if you study one study program, you can do a minor in another. We focus on practical learning, learning by doing. So our programs are a blend of theory and practice. And we offer bachelor's, master's, associate degree, and also pre-master programs. Here you can see an overview of all the programs we offer. Of course, you can find them also on our website, and I will go through them one by one briefly now. Built environment. This is focusing on mobility, urban planning, and urban design. This is one of the best programs in the Netherlands. And according to a Dutch study choice guide, this won the first prize in its own category. The Netherlands is very well known for its water management, and that is an important topic that you will learn about in this study program. As you might know, a large part of the Netherlands is actually under sea level, so the Netherlands, the Dutch people know very well how to treat the water. Facility management. This is a program which is not so well known abroad. Especially in the first year, there is some overlap with hotel management. For example, both the students for facility management and hotel management, they will work in our learning company called Sibelicious, which is a restaurant. And of course, now we have to deal with the COVID guidelines, but before that time, people from Breda could come there. So not only the students and the teachers, but also actual residents of Breda could come to that restaurant and have lunch or dinner there. And the students from hotel and facility would be cooking the meals, waiting tables. And it works in the way that you get more and more responsibility. So for example, as a second year student, you will be the manager of the first year. Specifically, facility management learns you how to arrange a pleasant, safe, healthy, and efficient work environment. So for example, if you are a facility manager in a company, you make sure that everyone has the right office furniture, that the light is correct, that there is the right temperature, but also that the building is like environmentally friendly. So there is a lot of aspects as a facility manager that you have to take care about. You learn about policy, strategy, sustainability, and also this program did win the first prize in its own category. Hotel management. There is a number of hotel management programs in the Netherlands and of course also worldwide. So what is special about ours? Well, first of all, we have our own in-house training company, like I just mentioned, Sibelicious. This is very unique. We have a cooperation with Hilton Hotel Group. So the top rated students, they can take part in the Hilton Honors class and also get an internship there. And eventually, of course, have the chance to get a job offer from Hilton Hotel Group. This is one of the best rated programs in the Netherlands. And what students give as their feedback about why they chose to study hotel at BUAS is that our hotel program is a bit more informal. It is very small scale, so there is a lot of individual attention and you can really choose the direction that you are interested in. Then we offer a number of programs in the domain leisure and events. So the first one that I would like to discuss is leisure and events management. Generally, all our study programs in the field of leisure events, they belong to the one out of just five world leisure centers of excellence. We have an extensive international network, which I will show you later. And this is a program, again, which has real-life assignments. You can choose your own tracks and really specialize in the kind of leisure that you are interested in. Then we have also a Bachelor of Science Leisure Studies. This is the only academic degree program in the field of leisure in the Netherlands. This is an interdisciplinary education preparing you for policy, strategy, or research. And again, this belongs to the one out of five World Leisure Centers of Excellence. For logistics, we have a number of programs. For the bachelor's, we have logistics management and logistics engineering. The first year of both of the programs are quite similar, but then you're going to specialize. And logistics management specializes in economic and finance, where logistics engineering specializes more on the technical and IT side of logistics. There is a special program for highly talented logistics students, including a scholarship. For media, we offer the Bachelor Creative Business, and here you learn about creative concepts, about media experiences, the latest trends, developments, scripts. There's several sides of media, so you will learn about TV, radio, social media, online, and again, you can specialize in the field you're interested in. We have our own production house where you can learn how to make radio, and you will also do a special internship to make either TV or radio in the Netherlands, or when it is safe to travel again, students can go to Houston in the USA. And this program did win the first prize in its own category. And for tourism, we also offer a number of programs. One of them is tourism management. As I mentioned, BUAS was founded in 1966, so we have 55 years of experience in the field of tourism. This is a broad economic degree program with focus on sustainable tourism, socioeconomic impact, digitization, and experience design. And there is many options to shape your studies, also plenty of opportunities for exchanges and internships. For tourism, we have also a Bachelor of Science in the field of tourism. This is organized together with Wageningen University and Research, a research university, where you will study 2 years in Breda and the third year in Wageningen. You study research developments in tourism and consequences for society, environment, and economy. And this is the only academic bachelor program in the field of tourism in the Netherlands. We have also a gaming program. It's called Creative Media and Game Technologies, and this is one of the best in the world and the first in the Netherlands. In this program, you will actually learn how to create games. You can choose different tracks. You can either focus on the virtual arts, on game development, and we have a brand new track, which is called Artificial Intelligence and Data Management. We have our own game studio where you will learn how to make the games. And from the first year onwards, you make both games individually, but also in project groups. So you will work together with students who chose a different track and together create a game. We have partnerships with Sony, Epic Games, and SideFX. I just mentioned briefly that we have a brand new track. This is a new differentiation within creative media and game technologies. And in this track, you will get courses about data science, AI, neural networks, programming in Python, ethics and law. And you will also do projects in a project lab, among which a project for the municipality of the city of Breda. Then I continue with our master program. So we were talking about games, so let's continue with that one. We have a master in game technology. This is all our masters are 1 year. And for this master, there's a year-long graduation, self-directed learning, and individual coaching. There's collaboration with the international game industry, and our lecturers, they are an international team, and they are professionals in their field. We offer a master in Imagineering, which is an MBA program. So if you're looking for a more innovative type of MBA, then this might be the program for you. This is about social and business innovations. New emerging companies, they are looking for different ways to do their business, and they are looking for other approaches. So you will learn about innovation by empowering creativity in a strategically envisioned direction. There is an international network of companies, universities, and alumni from diverse fields. And because you get access to this program with quite a wide range of bachelor programs, the group of students for this MBA program is very diverse. We have also a Master of Science, Leisure and Tourism Studies. Again, this falls under the domain of leisure, so it is part of the one of five centers of excellence. This is the only academic master in the field of leisure and tourism, and it has a very multidisciplinary approach. We have a new master in logistics, which is called Master Supply Chain Management. And this is the only study program which has an intake also in February. All the other ones, they have intake only in September. This one is new. The deadline for applying for the February intake was originally 16th of November, but I discussed with my students from student office, and if you are really interested in this, you can still apply until this Sunday, but then you should hand in your complete package by Sunday. So if you're interested, please look into it. Otherwise, of course, you can take part in the September intake. This teaches you how to organize and innovate supply chains, and we have close industry connections. For media, we offer the Master Media Innovation, and this learns you how to create new media concepts. This is in the top 10 of all Dutch professional masters, and it is a very successful blend of theory and practice. For tourism, we offer the Master Tourism Destination Management, and this teaches you how to develop strategies for responsible, resilient, and sustainable destination management. In normal situations outside of COVID, you start studying in Breda, and then you have 3 months of field research in different destinations. So you will study mostly in Southeast Asia and Australia, where you will look at an established tourist destination and also new tourist destinations. You will also look at the impact on the local people and the environment. There's a lot of peer learning, and the classroom is very international. After your field research, you can choose where to graduate. So you can either come back to Breda, or you can stay in one of those three field research destinations to do your graduation there. So these are all our study programs. We also offer two masters. One is strategic business management. This is part of the fourth year of a bachelor program. This is for like students who really want to do something extra. It has 75 ECTS instead of 60. And if you do this in your fourth year, then you get 2 degrees. So you get the bachelor diploma of the bachelor you are studying, and you also get a diploma for strategic business management. And then we have a pre-master in the field of leisure and tourism. So if you are interested to do a master in the field of leisure and tourism, but you don't have the right bachelor degree yet, then you can do this 1 year pre-master and then do the 1 year master afterwards. We focus a lot on talent development, the right student in the right place. And that's why for most of the study programs, we have some sort of assessment. So some of them, they really have an assessment in the sense that you will have to do a test, for example, for games. But the other ones, they have what we call study choice activities. And this is to make sure that this is really the right program for you. We do have 3-year tracks. This is for students who have done a higher secondary school education, so they can do the bachelor in 3 years instead of 4. The education is very personal, very flexible, so you can choose your own tracks, you can focus on the fields that you are interested in. We cooperate, like I mentioned, for example, with Hilton. We focus also on entrepreneurship. So if it is your ambition to start your own company, then you can do so and we will fully support you. And it is a central place for talent development, and our new campus is especially designed for that. So these are the two pre-master programs that I mentioned, Leisure and Tourism Studies and SBM, Strategic Business Management. Relevant research. So this is, of course, every domain does its own research, and our teachers are often asked, for example, by local journalists to comment on certain topics, especially now, for example, with COVID, people cannot travel. We have a lot of experience in tourism industry. So teachers are asked about that, among many other things. Our international students come from all over the world. We have around 70 international different student nationalities. And here you can see a map. We have also students from India. And these are our partner institutions also spread out around the world. We have a wide range of industry partners. I already named a couple like Hilton, but we also work together with KLM. Efteling is a Dutch amusement park very close to Breda. Then we work with a number of TV stations, with PlayStation, Ubisoft, Google, also other hotel chains like Marriott for logistics with UPS, built environment, a number of municipalities, and also the national government. So a wide range of big names where you can do internships. Also people from those companies give guest lectures. So there is a wide range of cooperation. We did receive international recognition from these organizations. So for example, from the World Leisure of Excellence, WNTO, and others. And besides that, also national recognition. So I mentioned that a number of our programs were ranked top rated or the first in their category. And we were also the best specialist university of applied sciences, both in 2018 and 19. So where can we find us? I named already that we are in the city of Breda, which is in the south of the Netherlands. It originated in 1251, so we are a very historic city. It is vibrant, safe, easy accessible, and as in many Dutch cities, there is a lot of water, like you can see on this picture. So this is a picture of the Netherlands within Europe. Breda is in the south, but since the Netherlands is so small, it is only 1 hour by train from Amsterdam and also 1 hour to Brussels. And it's very easy to take the train or plane to cities like London or Paris. And if you study in the Netherlands, you have a Schengen visa, so you can travel freely to all Schengen EU countries. This is our campus. So I explained a little bit about it already. This is our historic building, which is on the inside, totally renovated with all the latest technology. And we really focus on that all students can find a place to study by themselves or in project groups. Here you can see an overview of the campus with the three buildings. And they have all their own look and design. This is the inside of the old convent. This is another building and the third building. So unfortunately, I cannot travel now to visit you and to attend fairs, for example, or to visit the agents there. But we made other ways to connect. So we call it My Road to BIWAS. So how can your road to BIWAS be? We made several online orientation possibilities. For example, you can take a quiz, you can take a virtual campus tour, so you can see a little bit more about our campus. We have an online open day. The next one is coming up on Wednesday, the 26th. You can chat with our students via Ask a Student. So if you would like to talk to someone who is actually studying at BIWAS, you can do so via chat. We have a YouTube channel with videos about all our programs, about our campus, and we are on social media. So to find this, please take a look at our website. The link is here below, and click on Meet Us. Then a little bit about COVID, because I can imagine that it worries you. Also in the Netherlands, we have a second wave right now. It is slowly going down again. But yeah, of course, we follow government guidelines. Our campus is open, and according to the guidelines, we can receive 25% of capacity at one time, which means that just over 1,800 people, so that's students and staff, can be on the campus at the same time. And we do prioritize the first year students. So all the students, they have a schedule, and for each class, it is mentioned if it is on campus or online. And where students previously had all 5 days, Monday to Friday, on campus education, now that might be 2 times half day or like 1 full day. It depends the study program and the year you're in. We do offer support as much as we can. We have also a buddy system, and of course we focus on safety. So there is the cleaning has been intensified. A mask is at this moment still advised to wear, at least in the corridors, for example. In the classroom we have social distancing, so there it's not needed. We have walking directions. So, for example, on the stairs, you can go only one way instead of two ways. We offer a mask, so you can pick it up for free at our service desk. And when there is any important change, then we inform immediately. You can also find the updated COVID regulations on our website. Then the institution fees. So this is, of course, an important topic if you want to study abroad. What is it going to cost? So for this academic year, the cost for the bachelor's is 9,950, except for the joint degree with Wageningen University. That goes, the application goes via Wageningen University. Also the pre-master strategic business management is the same price. There is an exception for the pre-master leisure and tourism studies. Here, EU students and non-EU students pay the same. So this is only 2,168. For the masters, the price is for most of them 10,385, with exception of the leisure and tourism studies, the academic master, that is 12,248. These are the deadlines. So for all the bachelor programs, they are 1st of May. I mentioned a little bit about the selection. So here you can see the difference between the programs that have study choice activities, which is not binding, and programs that have selection and also a maximum amount of students. For example, Creative Media and Game Technologies has a maximum of 180 students per year. And the number of applicants is more than 500. So please be aware about this, that you prepare well if you want to apply for this program. The deadline is quite early because of the visa application process, which can take up to 8 weeks. For the master programs, the deadline is 1 month later, 1st of June. And as I mentioned, there is one exception. The master supply chain management starts also in February, and the deadline is 16th of November. But especially for you, the deadline is stretched up to this Sunday. So if you're interested, then please apply quickly. We do offer scholarships for students from India. We unfortunately only have scholarships for bachelor programs, not for master. The BUOS Bachelor Scholarship and the Orange Tulip Scholarship are the same in amount, which means that there is 3,000 euro for the reduction of the tuition fee in the first year and 1,500 euro in the executive years per year. The Holland Scholarship is a one-time scholarship of 5,000 euro. And here you can find our contact details. So if you are interested to apply, please contact Europe Study Center via this link. And if you would like to receive more information about Breda University of Applied Sciences, then please look on our website, www.buas.nl/en for English. And there you can find all the information about the study programs and also about the My Road to BUAS, the different ways to connect with us. So this was my presentation. I would like to give the word now to Apeksha to explain her experiences.
Can you hear me?
Yes, yes, I can hear you. Please go ahead if you're ready.
Yeah. Hi, everybody. I'm Apeksha Juneja, and I am a Master's of Leisure and Tourism Studies student at the Breda University of Applied Sciences. This is my second year because I started with the pre-master's program last September. and I graduated from the pre-master's program this August, and then from September I started with the master's program. So I got the BUAS, I got to know about the BUAS University through Study in Holland website. I was looking for an events program because I had my bachelor's degree at the University of Delhi, and it was in commerce honors, but I had an inclination towards event management. So I looked for event management courses in Europe, and I came across a course in leisure and events management at the Breda University of Applied Sciences through a Study in Holland website. So I applied to that course, and because I had a professional degree and it was an academic master's, so I was required to do the pre-master's program. Then, the application process was pretty smooth. So after that, I started with the pre-master's program here. And it is quite different from what I did in India, because this is a research master's. So it had a lot of qualitative and quantitative research throughout the study program. And it's the same has continued onto the master's. And I experienced the campus for around 6 months till March this year, because after that everybody was in lockdown due to COVID. But yes, the campus is beautiful and I have had quite a few good experiences there. And apart from the studies, the practical experience is pretty good here, because for other programs, all kinds of internships are offered, and for the academic masters, we have real life projects with companies. So last, in the pre-master's program, we did a quantitative research for Tivoli Vredenburg in Utrecht, and that's a concert organizer. So they organize events and we did research for them. Currently also, I am in a group project for museums in Amsterdam, doing research for them. So there are lots of opportunities to collaborate with companies here or international as well. And there are quite a few study associations at the university. I am part of one. I was a member last year, and this year I am the head of the association. We organize events and study sessions together for the students. So yeah, my experience has been pretty good. Any questions if you have apart from this?
Thank you for sharing your experiences. I see already a number of questions in the chat box. So let's just go through them one by one. And of course, if you have any other questions for me or for Apeksha, then please type them in the chat, then we will answer them. So the first question that I see is it possible to apply for a master's program for someone with a 3-year bachelor's degree? This is a bit of a problem with application for the master for students from India, because generally speaking, the 3-year bachelor in India is not equivalent to the 4-year bachelor in the Netherlands. So there, as I understood, India has a 4-year bachelor, but that is more focused on engineering. So generally speaking, the 3-year bachelor is not sufficient, which means that you would have to do a pre-master. Do we have a master in project management? It depends a bit what you, how you see project management, not under that title. But all our study programs, both the bachelor's and the master's, they prepare you for management in that specific domain. So depending on the field that you are interested in, please take a look on our website for the master's we offer. Are there any age restrictions for master's? No, we welcome everyone. So as long as you have the eligible pre-education, so if you're talking about master, if you have the right bachelor, then you can be admitted. So we don't look at age at all. Stay back opportunities. When you graduate, both for the bachelor or for the master, you can stay in the Netherlands for 1 year to look for a job. You have until 3 years after your graduation. So if you would wish to go back to India first, that is possible. So you could go back to India for a year and then still come back to the Netherlands for a year. And then if you find a job and your employer arranges for you the work permit, then you can stay, of course, longer. But based on your graduation, you can stay for 1 year. Do we get a work permit for spouses? As an institute, we do arrange the visa for you, and we have also arranged spouse visas. I'm not sure about the work permit. I would have to look into that. So for this very specific question, please contact one of the agents at Europe Study Center. And if needed, they can get in contact with me to look this up. Course details for the masters. This is very specific because we have a number of masters, but the course details, they are explained on our website. So for more information about that, please take a look. We also do offer webinars for every study program specifically, and there a teacher and a student will explain to you very specifically what you will learn in that study program. So also take a look at that. Indeed, Danya mentioned some useful links in the chat. So, for example, according to the Shanghai ranking, we are the number one in the Netherlands in the field of hospitality and tourism management. What is the minimum eligibility for a scholarship? To receive a scholarship, you should first apply for the study program, and then depending on the scholarship that you want to apply for, you have to write a letter where you explain what you want to study and why you should be granted this scholarship. I must say that for the BUAS scholarship, we have a number of focus countries, and India is one of them. So students from India are one of the nationalities that are given preference to be granted this scholarship. You can find the details for the scholarship application on our website. Is it mandatory to do pre-masters? No, it's not mandatory. It depends on your study background and what you want to study. When you apply, a student office will recommend you to do the pre-masters if needed. And yeah, as I mentioned, with some study backgrounds, you don't have access to the masters directly, so you can do so via a pre-master. What is the duration of pre-master? Both our pre-masters and our masters are all 1 year. So if you need to do the pre-master and then the master, then it's in total 2 years. What are the job opportunities while studying and after studies? As a non-European student, you can work maximum 16 hours, or you can work 3 months full-time in the summer. There's that choice. While studying, most of our students that are working, they find weekend evening jobs in, for example, restaurants. Or in the event industry, when there are big events organized, they are working there. Of course, now in COVID times, it's a little bit tough time for international students to find a job. Also as, for example, to deliver food, there's different ways. And then we work also with student ambassadors. So we hire a number of students from different countries to represent us at fairs, or nowadays virtual fairs, to do open days, to do our social media, to ask questions from other students. So there's also that option to become a student ambassador. After studies, as I mentioned, you can stay 1 year in the Netherlands after you graduate. And yeah, there is of course students who find a job in the Netherlands. I must say that Breda is a quite small city, 180,000 students. So most of our students who find a job in the Netherlands after graduating, they find a job in cities like Amsterdam and Rotterdam. But Rotterdam is less than half an hour away by train, and Amsterdam is only 1 hour. So it is all relatively small. But those cities, they are more international, and I would say it's easier to find a job there. what is the difference between master and executive master? Yes, on purpose, I didn't mention specifically the executive master because, unfortunately, according to Dutch government regulations, the executive masters are not accessible for non-European students. The difference is that for an executive master, you need to have some work experience already, and they are usually part-time. Please let us know the accommodation details. We do have a campus, but in the Netherlands, it is not common that there are dormitories on campus. And that is the same in the at BUAS. But we do help you to find a room. So if you apply at BUAS and you are admitted, then in June, July period, you receive an email from student office with the question if you want to make use of the room offer that is arranged by BUAS. So that means that we are in connection with a number of housing agents, and we can arrange a room for you, which is then a one-year rental contract. It's a furnished room. Otherwise, students find rooms via, for example, Facebook groups, and also via a number of websites which we can provide you. On our website, you can find a special page about housing. So there you can see the links and you can click them to have an idea about what a room would look like. A room costs on average 400 euro per month. And that means that you have your private bedroom, but you share the toilet and the kitchen with other students. Usually you share it with two or three other people. Should you wish to have your own apartment or studio apartment, then that is around 550, 600 euros per month, depending on the location. If you are willing to move a little bit out of the city center, then it gets slightly cheaper. What are the English language requirements? For IELTS, it's 6.0, including 6.0 for speaking. And for TOEFL in that base, it's 80. We also accept Cambridge, 169. So that's the English language requirements. At this moment, unfortunately, we don't accept Duolingo. This is, again, government regulations. I know that some countries accept them. Speaking is important for us because there's a lot of group work. So that's why we require specifically 6.0 for speaking. Admission procedure for masters. This again is a little bit different per master program, but you need to have a bachelor in a relevant field. And again, it depends the master. Like I mentioned, the MBA program is quite broad. So we, for that one, we do accept quite wide range of bachelors. Then you need to have your English test result, and for some you need to write a motivation letter. So that really depends. If you look on our website, on the master where you're interested in, you can see the details of the admission and also the selection procedure. Maybe Apeksha, can you share a little bit more about your admission procedure for your master?
Yes. So when first I applied for the master's, I got back that my degree wasn't enough for the master's program because I had a 3-year bachelor's. So then I reapplied for the pre-master's. Then, it was pretty smooth. I had to submit all my documents along with the motivation letter and my transcripts and passports and the IDs through the portal on the BUAS website. And after that, I got my decision. And the visa process entirely was handled by the university. I had to just submit my documents. They forwarded it to the IND. And then I got the notification. I just had to go to the embassy one day to get my MVV stamped on the passport. That was, just one day. Otherwise, it was all online. The documents were sent. And then when I came here, I picked up my residence permit. So that's the admission procedure, though.
Yeah, thank you. I wanted to add, someone was asking about English language requirements. This is not about English, but we do not ask for GMAT. I know that this is also a question which is asked often, but that's not needed. Someone has a 16-year gap. Can I get admission? This is not any limitation, at least to get access, as long as you have the right motivation and the right pre-education, you can get admission. So that is definitely not a limiting factor. For the master, we have students of more wide range of ages. I must say that should you wish to apply for a bachelor, most of our students are around 18 years old. So this is, I don't mean to say that you would not be admitted, but please be aware that then most students would be quite younger. Are there any prerequisite for MBA application? So for the MBA program Imagineering, we do accept quite a wide range of bachelor programs. Working experience is definitely a plus, but for example, if you have done an internship, we also see that as work experience. And all the other details, please check our website for those. You can find them all listed there. There is a question if we have masters in electronics engineering. No, we don't offer masters in that specifically. Then the closest would be the master supply chain management, but that's more in the field of logistics. So unfortunately not. Can a spouse travel with students? Yeah, as I explained before, we did offer spouse visa for student, but if the spouse can work, I would have to look that up. So please do contact Europe Study Center for that. Okay, are there any other questions? Please don't hesitate to ask. Can you please share the website? Yes. So this is both the website of Europe Study Center and also of Breda University of Applied Sciences. So it's www.buas.nl/en for English. Students having 55% in bachelor's are eligible. I'm not sure what you mean with 55%, if that is the results, your test results. I'm not sure. As long as you have passed for your bachelor exams, if you have your bachelor diploma, that should be enough. My students from student office, they will check all the diplomas and the grades, and then they will let you know if you can be accepted. What is the turnaround time to process applications? The application process has four steps. The first step is that you make an account in StudiLink. That is a link under the Dutch government. And for all Dutch institutions, that is the same. So you first go to StudiLink. Then you make an account there. After that, you make an account on my online application. Don't worry, you all receive links for this, so you don't need to remember step by step. And in my online application, that is step two, you can upload all your documents. So your diploma, either your high school diploma or your bachelor diploma, your list of the courses you took with the grades, your English test result, if needed, motivation letter. So this is all specified on the website, and you receive emails of what you need to apply. If you still have to do your high school exam, for example, don't worry, because you can upload already your list of courses or the latest list of grades that you have. and mention I will do my exam, for example, in May, and I expect my diploma in June or in July. And then you can be conditionally admitted based on the other documents, on the condition that you do supply your diploma. So if that one is then indeed coming, then everything is fine. So just upload the documents as soon as you have them. Then step number three is that you do either the study choice activities or the selection, if that is part of your study program of choice. And step four is the payment of tuition fees. When you submit all your documents, so in step two, we aim to come back to you within 5 working days. But this, again, it depends a little bit on the program where you apply to. And if you apply just before the deadline of 1st of May, then we are very, very busy. So then it might take a bit longer. But I would say the earlier you apply, the sooner you get a reply from student office, because then their work is a bit more spread out. What are the deadlines for the MBA intake 2021? So the MBA program starts 1st of September 21, and the deadline is 1st of June. Can we get work visa after the course? And for how many years? You can stay for 1 year after you graduate. Is spouse get work visa during the course? Yeah, so as I explained, we did arrange visa for spouses to come to the Netherlands together with the student. If they can work, I would have to look into. Stay back options, 1 year. Per year, how much cost for overall? Okay, so as a non-European student, you have to apply. You have to transfer a certain amount of money in advance. So you pay the tuition fee. So the tuition fee is for the bachelor's 9,950, and for the master's it's 10,385 for most of them, but except for one study program, which is 12,000. And then you have to pay for the visa application fee. So that is in total 275. Then there is insurance. And you have to pay for means of sufficient funds. All in all, this means that you transfer around 21,000 euro to Breda University of Applied Sciences. But part of that will be transferred back to you in monthly installments. So the means of sufficient funds is around 11,000, and this one will be transferred back from September onwards in monthly installments, and that you can use to pay your room and to pay for groceries. So this is a kind of deposit. It is not something that we take completely. So then the monthly expenses that you have is on average 400 per month for a room. Then there is insurance, your groceries. So most students, depending on your spending level, spend between 700 and 1,000 per month for all these things. Do you have an MBA in digital marketing? If you're interested in digital marketing, please take a look at our master media innovation that is focusing on that, among other things. If a student gets the job, can the work visa be extended or the employer will be sponsored? Yeah, so in that 1 year that you can stay back, if you do find a job in the Netherlands, then your employer should arrange the work visa for you. So working visa is not something that we arrange as a university. We arrange the student visa, but you have 1 year time to find a job, and then the employer will have to take care of your working visa. What about medical insurance during the stay? The medical insurance, we can advise you in that, and the costs are around 480 euro per year. Do we have March 21 intake? No, we have only one master, which is supply chain management and the logistics, which has an intake on 1st of February 2021. This is a brand new master, and that is why we have two intakes, but that is the exception. And for that one, the deadline is this Sunday, so please apply fast. Okay, I don't see any new questions anymore, but we have still some time. So if you have any questions left, then please let me know. If you have any questions later, don't hesitate to contact the agents via Europe Study Center, and if needed, they can contact me directly. What are the career options after the MBA program? This is very broad. So you are really educated as someone who can innovate a business, who is a strategist. So most of our students, they either start their own company. For example, we have two students from Brazil, and they started to be an agent for us. So they recruit students from Brazil to work for us, but it's in all kind of fields. That was just an example. Other alumni, they find jobs in companies, and they are really trained as a consultant to see how can we make this company better, how can we improve it, and that can be in all kind of fields. Like, it can be that the digital marketing of that company is not according to the latest requirements, or that too much money is spent on the logistics part of things, or on human resources. So you're really trained to look at the company as a whole and to find ways to improve and innovate that company or your own. What is the duration of the master? All our masters are 1 year. What is the tenure for supply chain management? Supply chain management is our new master. This is created in collaboration with the industry. And let me look some latest information. It focuses a lot on the on data-driven supply chain decisions. Here you learn how to organize and innovate supply chains. We work in an international team of lecturers and professionals, and this is really responding to the latest supply and demand of the supply chain leaders of the future. The Netherlands is a very unique destination for logistics. We have the harbor in Rotterdam, which is one of the biggest in the world. Also Amsterdam Schiphol Airport, a very large airport where there is a lot of cargo, for example, not coming just to the Netherlands, but then transferred to the rest of Europe. So originally we have, as the Netherlands, a lot of experience in logistics and how to use this in the most efficient way. And as a master supply chain management student, you really look at these latest ways and how to innovate it even further. The total cost for the supply chain management program is 10,385 euros. The maximum age, we have no age limit at all for the bachelor's or the master's. The university is government funded. We are not a private university, and that is why our costs are relatively low. If you look at other institutions that offer MBAs, the costs can easily be 40,000 euros. Our master and MBA programs, they can be relatively cheap because we are government funded. What is the IELTS requirement? I will quickly double check. For most of our programs, the IELTS requirements are 6.0. But let me check specifically for supply chain management. So So for supply chain management, you need to have a bachelor in logistics or a bachelor degree with a major or minor in logistics. There are exemptions for this, and that is based on individual cases. So if you don't have a bachelor in logistics, but you are very much interested, or maybe you have some working experience, then please do apply and explain your background, and then you can discuss that further in an interview. The IELTS is indeed 6, with a minimum subscore of 6 for speaking. TOEFL is 80 internet-based, and Cambridge is 169, so this is same as for our bachelor programs. Currently, I'm studying in the 12th science. Can I apply for undergraduate in September 21 intake? I think, excuse me. I think you're talking about bachelor programs. So if you have the right high school diploma, then you definitely can apply for the intake. My colleagues from student office, they will evaluate your diploma. So from this, it is very difficult for me to evaluate. It depends the exact level of your education and the name of your diploma. But in principle, yes. What about Erasmus exchange for students? Which countries can students go to for semester exchange? This depends on the study program of your choice. We have exchanges with other countries, both in the EU as outside of the EU, for all study programs. And we have partner universities all around the world. So this depends a bit which study program you're interested in and where you can go for exchange. We have a number of options that we offer as an institute. But if you have certain interests by yourself, you can always discuss this with your teachers. Are there any other questions? I see there was one question about internships. There are definitely internships available. That is one of the things that we focus on a lot, because we focus on a blend of theory and practice. So for every study program, especially in the bachelor's, there's at least a one-time 5-month internship, sometimes even more. And in the master's, you do your own research. So that, again, it depends a bit the study program, but there are definitely internships. How much will students get if they go for a semester exchange? I'm not sure if you mean now a kind of salary for internship. Again, this depends the company where you do your internship. So the one company will offer more than the other. From Breda University of Applied Sciences, there is no like minimum or there is no guidelines. Most companies, they pay something, or they pay, for example, for your accommodation in that specific country. But yeah, this depends. I cannot give a kind of one answer to this. You don't get any allowance from Breda University. This comes then from the company. I see one more question. Is IELTS required for master course? Yes. So for most of our courses, the IELTS requirement is 6. Then there was question stipend for semester exchange. So I'm not sure what you mean. If you get an is the question if you get an allowance for semester exchange? Not from Breda University. I don't know if that is normal in India. Do we have a computer science program available in the bachelor? What we offer is our bachelor creative media and game technologies. But that is very specifically to create video games. That is not general IT. Most of our study programs, they are quite specific in a certain field. Okay, please let me know if you have any questions left for me or for Apeksha. Don't hesitate to ask. Also, if you're wondering about the city of Breda or studying there, how is the life for an international student, just any question you might have, we are happy to answer them. During Erasmus, will the living expenses be covered? This is not something we specifically offer, so please contact the agent about the details of Erasmus. For the scholarships that we offer specifically, there is only deduction of the tuition fee of 3,000 in the first year and 1,500 in the consecutive years, or the one-time 5,000 Holland scholarship. But that is then deduction of the tuition fee, so that is not covering living expenses specifically. Our masters are 1 year. Are there any further questions? Tanya, is there anything from your side you'd like to add? Okay, I see there is still a few more questions. Before we round up, I will answer those. Is there a combined degree of Bachelor of Computer Science? We do offer a bachelor in the field of game technologies, but not generally computer science. And about the work permit for the spouse, we did offer visas to come to the Netherlands for a spouse of a student. If that spouse is then allowed to work, I would have to look into. This is a very specific question. It doesn't happen so often. So please do ask your question to your agent of Europe Study Center, and if needed, the agent can contact me for further details. This is something that my colleagues from student office would arrange, so I would have to look into that. I don't dare to say yes or no at this moment. Okay, I think that's all the questions. Please contact Europe Study Center if you have any questions later, or of course if you want to apply. And if you want to receive more information about Breda University of Applied Sciences, then please look at our website. You can find all the details about the courses, about the application, about selection procedures, tuition fee, also a breakdown of the costs of everything you would have to pay for each specific study program. I see one last question coming in. In Netherlands, food accommodation is best for international students? Yeah, so accommodation, it might be a bit different than in India. Most students, they live in a student house, especially the bachelor students, where you have your own room, but you share the kitchen and the bathroom with a number of other students. And food is very different. Maybe Apeksha wants to share some personal experience with that. But in the Netherlands, we eat a lot of bread. And our lunch is quite simple. We definitely don't have a large warm meal for lunch. But maybe please share something how you feel.
Yeah, so the normal food is here, bread, cheese and everything. But there's no problem because you'll find all the vegetables at the grocery shops. And also there are Indian stores. Even in Breda, there are Indian stores, or you can order Indian grocery online. So I don't think there's any problem of food.
Yeah, and there's, for example, in cities like Rotterdam and The Hague, there are bigger Oriental shops. So if you really want to do some big shopping, then you can go there. It's quite close by. For the students who eat vegetarian, we always have vegetarian options, so don't worry about that.
Yeah, even the campus cafeterias all have vegetarian options, and also the restaurants, there are Indian restaurants in Breda also, so I don't think there's a problem for food.
Then there is a question about the climate. I think it gets, depending where in India you are, I think the Netherlands can get colder. So it is autumn now. We do have four seasons, and the summers don't get very hot. I would say on average around 25 degrees. It can get over 30, but usually quite short amount of time. And then there is thunder and rain, and then the temperature cools down again. So now it is springtime, but because of the climate change, winters are not as cold anymore, and summers they are tend to be more warm than they used to be. There can be snow, but usually it is not that cold that the snow remains for a long time. So then it stays for a couple of days and then it melts away again. I must say that in the Netherlands we do have some rainy days. Okay, I think with this we come to the end of this session. I very much welcome you to apply, and I hope it was informative for you. Okay, have a good day.
Thank you.